Hey, you guys. So this is another hair tutorial and this is going to be a voiceover. So I got me a retro puff girl. This is a size large by the brand Instinct Glitz. And of course, it's a synthetic drawstring ponytail available at no other than samsbeauty.com. So this does come in other sizes, but I decided to opt for the large. So the first thing first, girl, I'm going to unbraid my own natural hair. I keep it like this when I'm doing my wigs, but most of the time I just wear it out in the bun. You know, my edges have grown back in a little bit, so you know. But anyway, so I hope you guys are all having like a really great day today. You know, divas, devos, trolls, you know, whoever may be deciding to watch this. I hope you guys are having a really great day. So I'm going to go ahead and spritz the back of my hair with some water that does have conditioner in it. I like to do that because it just makes my hair brush up a whole lot easier versus spraying a whole bunch of hairspray or gel in it. I'll just spray a little bit of water and I'm good to go. And I'm going to be using one of my favorite hairbrushes just to brush the sides up. Now let me tell y'all, good thing I have been working out because brushing your hair up in a high ponytail is a workout in itself, you know, but I've been doing this every day, so you get your arm workout going. And the brush that I'm using actually right now is a detangling brush. I love this brush. I got it from Amazon. It's like 11 bucks. It's the best thing ever, especially if you have curly hair, then this brush is perfect. And now I'm going to go ahead and take one of those headbands, you know, the headbands that you can get from the Dollar Tree. Well, I like to pop mine open. You can cut them open. And I just take them and go around like that so I can get myself a ponytail. I know you could do it the other way, but it seems like when I have to pull the hair through, the ponytail never comes out properly. So the best and easiest way for my ponytail to come out perfect is to wrap it around several times, okay? And then I'm just going to take my hair and pretend like I'm making a bun like I normally do. But we already know what the deal is. You see that brush? Girl, the brush is everything. It has like these little finger-like sections. Perfect brush, girl. Gotta get it. And maybe Sam's Beauty sells it. I'm not really sure. But if I remember, I'll try to look on there and see. So that way when you order this ponytail retro puff size large, you can get that brush to go with it as well. Now I'm going to be using my edge control. And I just take a little bit of this and I just put it on the edges. But I also do a little bit extra because I don't like brushing my hair too hard. You know, when you brush your edges too hard, girl, that's how you lose them. So, you know, you got to be tender, like you tender headed. And as you see, they are growing back in a little bit, girl. Hello. I've been consistent with using the hair growth stuff. Like, I've been consistent on a lot of things, okay? So I'm gonna just take my toothbrush here. I know it's not the green one, but trust me when I tell you, that toothbrush is still around. The bristles are not as hard or are not as soft as that blue one I was using. So now I'm gonna just take my comb and I'm gonna brush some of that hair forward. I'm gonna also take that same spritzing bottle of water with conditioner in it, spritz it on my toothbrush to allow the hairs to come down oh so natural. I know you guys are like, girl, why did you do all of that? Yeah, I know. I didn't even need to do all the extra work, but it is what it is. And you want to make sure that your head is clean. So what you see me brushing was actually foundation. Because, you know, a girl has to be glamour divified, you know, even though I have been working all day. Like, this is like the last video of the day. This is the 9th wig that I put on my daggone head for today. And by the time that I was doing this video, it was like 12 o'clock at night. So as you can tell, some of my makeup on partial of my face was already removed off, you know, oily skin. It'll do it to you all the time. So that's why you can see half of my freckles right there. But I just like to make the baby hairs how I like to make them. You don't have to do this. This step is optional. But, you know, I got a long head, okay? So I try to camouflage it. And then I go back in with that same edge gel. I don't know why I do it once brushing up and then brushing down. That is wasting hair edge stuff. It is. I have to stop doing that. It's a force of habit, though. You know? Now I'm going to be just doing the opposite side, but I'm now going to be taking one of my very affordable hair gels or whatever you want to call it. Y'all know how y'all love the got to be hair gel. That's probably like $6-$7. I mean, like, listen, if you want to save like $2, then try this hair gel out that I'm about to show you guys. You can thank me later for it, but it is available at Walmart and it's the Quait Men Styling and Spiking Hair Gel. I've been using this stuff for a couple of years. years now. I'm not really sure why they call it men's, but it's just like the got to be. This stuff really does work and holds my hair down. I absolutely love it. It does dry clear and it will hold your wig down too if you want it to. I don't use it for that. I use it for the baby hairs and brushing up in the ponytail because those little that little edge control stuff right there, girl, please, that is not going to really hold my edges down like that. Y'all may think like, girl, no, you got this. No, girl, I don't. My edges will curl up, wave up too. So I have to put this on top of it, but I don't like to put this directly on it because it's a little bit stronger formula. So I like to put water in that edge control, give it a little greasy hold. You know what I'm saying? So now here's the fun part by the Insinklets Drawstring Synthetic Retro Puff Ponytail. Now I got it in the color number 4 and it does have two combs and a drawstring. Now listen, girl, when you put this thing on, make sure you put it on right. You don't want to be walking down the street and stuff thinking you cute, because I know that's what a lot of y'all do. Y'all think y'all real cute and stuff. Be bopping and weaving and then your ponytail puff just fly off. You know what I'm saying? Like, there be a lot of little windy days out here in Arizona. Even though it's hot air, that hot air be blowing. And I would not want to see somebody's puff blowing down the street like, you know, some tumbleweed. So make sure you got that on properly. And also make sure that you got that drawstring tucked away. Girl, you don't want to be outside with that drawstring hanging from the back of your hair. You know, you got to fake it till you make it. And when you're trying to fake something till you make it, you don't want to show the drawstring. So my best thing to advise you guys is make sure you grab onto that drawstring and tuck it around like you're going to see me doing right here. I always take a hairpin and tuck it in because that's just the best thing ever since sliced bread, the hairpins. Gotta make sure that my hair puff ain't my drawstring ain't going anywhere. But look, I just noticed that you can just really like do different styles with this. You just got to know how to hook it up. But I think it's big and fun and cute. I'm not really too fond of it like this. Kind of reminds me of like, I look like a tree, a broccoli, I don't know, but I'm just going to take it and I'm just going to gather some of it up and then I'm going to make the puff a lot smaller, you know, by taking one of my headbands like this one that I just wrapped around my head, and I'm going to wrap it here, tuck the hair under with a couple of bobby pins, and then you'll see what I do. Yeah, it might be a big ponytail, big, but it's not so wild and all over the place. I just got a long head, honey. I don't need anything extra to elongate it or to widen it. But I do like this puff ponytail because you can do other styles versus what I'm doing. So now you see I'm pulling it out after I've tucked it down, just so that way you can see the hairs. I didn't want it like that. Look at that. Cute. Hello. Big high puff ponytail. If my hair was this thick, I wouldn't even know what to do with myself. I'd be telling everybody they could, you know what. Now, I thought I would jazz it up with some of these hair barrettes from the Dollar Tree. Aren't they cute? You get a two-piece pack for a dollar and they're gold butterflies. But that wasn't it, girl. I had to style it. That's also from the Dollar Tree XOXO, babe. It says you can either get those in gold and silver, hunties. Dollar Tree is coming through. But I did buy two packs of these butterflies just for this wig right here. And I thought I would put all four of them in my hair. Cute, hunties. Cute. One of my subscribers showed me how to spell cute. I know it's not a word really in a dictionary, in case some of you don't know what a dictionary is. It's a book where you can look up words and find out what their meaning is and correct spelling, somewhat like an encyclopedia. But anyway, check this out. She looked rather cute, you know what I'm saying? You can definitely check out Sam's Beauty for this beauty. I think it's on sale. Don't get me to lying. But either way, I love you all. Make sure you rate, comment, subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Go, go, go. Go, 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 yeah. So I can focus, I just need to focus.